We have got the weirdest type of snow. It's literally like walking on sugar. It's just like tiny little bits, like tiny little bits of hail. It's the weirdest thing. It sounds so weird, especially on the barn roof that's metal, and it feels so weird as I'm walking on it. Good morning, rabbit lovers. Welcome to the Happy Harvest Homestead. Today, I thought it'd be fun to do a little bit of rabbit genealogy or family history and go over our breeders and how they are related to each other and just all that fun stuff. As you guys know, we currently have 6 breeders in our colony. Ivanhoe is our buck. Our herd queen is Elodie. We also have Ivy and Acrobat and Zuzu and Iantha. Oh, I guess I also forgot to mention Ronwin, our buck. He's not in the colony. He's our secondary backup buck, but he is part of the Mute Rabbit breeders, kind of, I guess. So we'll just include him in this as well. Elodie is the only Mute Rabbit breeder we have who we bought as an adult from a different homestead. The rest of our breeders were either born here or bought when they were young and raised here. I guess before I start getting into who is related to who and how, I should give you guys a little backstory. I might have told this to you guys before, but I don't remember, and if I did, it was a long time ago. So let me go over a brief history of our rabbits and start from the beginning of our rabbit family tree. About, I think it was 4 or 5 years ago, we started getting rabbits. We first got Angora rabbits for fiber, then we got Mute rabbits as well. As part of those original Mute rabbits, we got a half American, half New Zealand chinchilla colored buck named Snow. We actually thought he was a doe when we bought him, but then he turned out to be a boy. So we just kept him as our breeding buck. Also part of those original group of Mute rabbits was Lolo. She was a full New Zealand black doe. And then Abby, our New Zealand white doe, completes the trio of core breeders that are the common ancestors for most of our breeders today. In addition to being the beginning of our line of rabbits, these 3 were also the beginning rabbits in our first ever colony, and that was really fun to try out and build. We made a lot of mistakes and thankfully learned from most of them. But I have a special place in my heart for all 3 of these guys because we shared so many experiences and I enjoyed them and learned from them so much. So we had these rabbits for a while, then we ended up selling them to some friends of ours and purchasing 2 different core meat breeder rabbits who are also part of this lineage or line of rabbits that we have, Rosemary, or Rosie for short, and Basil. So for a while, we had Rosie and Basil, and then we eventually ended up keeping one of their daughters who we named Peppermint or Pepper, but mostly it was just Rosie and Basil. Pepper, at that time, was too young to be like an actual breeder, and she didn't have her first litter until we had other rabbits in the colony. And that brings us back to how we brought back some of the original rabbit blood we had. We bought Lolo back from our friends, who didn't want her anymore. So now we had Rosie, Basil, Pepper, their daughter, and Lolo. Then Lolo and Basil had kits, and we kept one of their daughters, Ivy. And that's the same Ivy we have still in our colony today. So her genealogy is pretty easy and fast. We can trace her very easily back to her mom was an original breeder, and then her dad was a sort of original breeder, and she is the first generation of rabbits we kept on our homestead here. So looking here at my records, I have Rosie and Basil's pedigree that we got from the breeder who we bought them from. So we do have Ivy's father's lineage. This is him, Basil. Grandparents, and then great-grandparents, and then even some multiple great-grandparents. But all we know about Lolo is that she's a New Zealand doe. We don't have her lineage or anything. So Ivy's family history is the easiest one to tell you guys about. The rest of the rabbits, they're very complicated, which is sort of a good thing because we have a lot more information about their family and their parents and grandparents and all that stuff, but then it also takes a long time to tell you guys. And because they're partially inbred or linebred, it's kind of really confusing, so I will try my best to explain it properly. I guess let's start with Ronwin, because we kept a whole bunch of his daughters, and so I guess it'd be good to explain him first, and then so that his daughters will make more sense. Okay, so since the pencil's kind of hard for you guys to read, I'll just kind of point out what it says. So Ronwin is the rabbit in question we're talking about. Maybe we should go back. Yeah, maybe we should start from the back and then go forwards because it'll make more sense. Okay, you were already introduced to Snow. So Snow and Lolo had a daughter. Her name was Petal. And our friends kept Petal and bred her to Marshmallow. Now, Marshmallow's mom was Abby and his dad was Snow. So they're like half siblings. So Petal and Marshmallow had a daughter whose name was Mira. And she's the mother of Ronwin. So here's where it gets a little bit complicated. So Mira was bred with her dad, Marshmallow, whose mom is Abby and whose dad is Snow. So Ronwin's dad is the same as his grandfather. One of the bad things about inbreeding is that it's really confusing saying like grandfather or half uncle or whatever. It kind of gets confusing when you have pedigrees. So, but that's Ronwin for you. So I guess so far we've covered Ronwin, we covered Elodie's heritage, and Ivy. I guess next let's move on to Zuzu. Now that we have explained Ronwin's pedigree, it'll be easier to explain her. So Zuzu is the daughter of Sayla and Ronwin. You guys may recall that we bought a Harlequin doe around the same time we bought Ronwin, so they were about the same age. And she had her first litter with Barlow, and then her second litter she had with Ronwin. And we kept Zuzu from her second litter. And Zuzu, as a baby, she was so cute. I love Harlequin kits. They just look so fun. I did not get a pedigree or anything with Sayla. So we just know Zuzu's mom, and that's where it stops. But then on her dad's side, so let's just use Ronwin's pedigree. There would be Zuzu, and then Sayla, and then Ronwin was the dad. Mira was the grandma. Petal was the great-grandma. Lola was the great-great-grandma. And then so on and so on. And then it gets a little bit complicated because of the whole bred with her father thing with Mira and Marshmallow. But you kind of get the idea. And then Iantha and Ivanhoe are, I guess, actually really easy to explain. With Ivanhoe, our friends sold some rabbits to some other friends of ours, and then we bought Ivanhoe from them. So we have no idea how he is related to whoever, but we know they're part of the Snow and Abby and Lolo line. We just don't know how exactly his ancestry goes, but we know he is kind of part of that somehow. And then we know Iantha's father was Ronwin, but we don't know who her mama was. She was just one of the kits who survived the Pasteurella epidemic that we had. Was that last spring? I guess it was, yeah. So we kept her as a breeder just because she survived the Pasteurella. She was like one of a whole bunch of orange kits from multiple mamas. There was just like a whole bunch of orange babies. So we don't know who her mama is, but we do know her dad is Ronwin. And then our final breeder, Doe Acrobat, is the one who is carrying on the basal line. So she's kind of that link between the new group of old breeders and the oldest group of breeders. Though I'm not 100% sure on her lineage. She, kind of like Iantha, was just a kit who survived the Pasteurella, so we kept her. But I have very, very likely suspicions on who her mama is. Because of her personality and her body structure and how her fur looks and just all these things, she's like inherited from her mother, most likely. I am really, really pretty sure that she is Henwin's daughter. She has the same personality as Henwin. She like loves people and she loves petting and she licks your hand all the time and she chews your shoes and all these adorable things, just like her mama did. Whenever she's pregnant, just like her mama, her belly gets really big. The way her fur looks and her body, whenever it looks and like whenever it's pregnant versus not pregnant, it just reminds me so much of her mama. Well, I guess who I'm assuming is her mama, Henwin. So I'm really pretty sure that they're mother and daughter. You guys might not remember, but Henwin is the daughter of Rosie and Basil. She's Pepper's sister, full sister, who we originally just kept her as an experiment kit in like to see if we could raise rabbits on only grass in a tractor, and it really worked, and she got older and older, and then I decided to keep her as a breeder, and she had huge litters, and she was super friendly, and I kind of really do miss her. As is the case with most of these breeders I'm talking about, she passed away. I actually had to cull her because she got Pasteurella, but her daughter, Acrobat, survived and didn't get Pasteurella, didn't show any symptoms, so that is good that we were able to keep that good genetic from her daughter that her mother didn't have. So then, on her mother's side, we know her genealogy really well. We have Acrobat, Henwin, Rosie, Basil, and then all these other rabbits. So we have that traced back pretty far. And then, We are in doubt as to who her father was. It's possible it was Barlow. And if that is the case, then we have his pedigree. I don't have in here, but we can trace his pedigree back really far as well. Or it could have been Ronwin, and we have his pedigree here too. So I guess no matter who her dad is, I don't remember if it's like there's a rule, like you need 6 generations of recorded parents and grandparents and all that stuff to be considered a pedigreed rabbit or whatever. I don't know, that kind of seems familiar. I could be getting it way wrong though. But then I guess that makes Acrobat our only fully pedigreed meat mutt rabbit. Most of the rest of them have partial pedigrees, but she is the only one who has a full pedigree. So, Ronwin, Ivanhoe, Iantha, Zuzu, Acrobat, Ivy, and Elodie. That's 7, right? So that's all of our meat rabbits we have currently. So, Elodie is related to nobody. Ivy and Acrobat are related. I guess Ivy would be Acrobat's aunt, because Basil is Ivy's dad, and Basil is Acrobat's grandfather. So, like, half aunt and half niece. Or I don't know, but they are related through Basil. Yeah, I guess Ivy is carrying the Basil line as well. So, I forgot about that. And then Iantha and Zuzu, and possibly Acrobat, are related through Ronwin, who is obviously related to all of them because he's their dad. Except for Acrobat, we're not entirely sure. And then it's possible Iantha is somehow related to the other rabbits as well. I guess she could be Henwin's daughter as well and be direct sisters with Acrobat. Or she could just be, like, Rinna's daughter, who we don't have any of Rinna's kids kept as breeders. So she could be, like, not related on her mom's side to anyone. Or she could be another one of Sayla's daughters and then be Zuzu's, like, full sister. She could be related to Ivanhoe somehow. Ivanhoe could be related in many ways to any of these guys too. Because we don't know their direct lineage, we don't know how they're related to everyone else. We just know that somehow they are. I don't know about you guys, but I have really enjoyed diving into this and explaining it all and reminding myself of all of this. This has been really fun for me, talking about rabbit family history and genealogy and lines and breeding and parents and taking a walk down memory lane, remembering some of my favorite rabbits who sadly have passed away. And I guess you guys know a lot of these rabbits who passed away who I'm talking about too. So like, maybe like me, it's fun to know, oh, that's Henwin's daughter. She's running around the colony still. There's a little bit of Henwin in there still. That's the fun thing about lion breeding, is that you can have multiple generations, and they're all like one big family. And to me, that's much more fun than just buying more breeders every time you want a new breeder, or to replace one who passes away, or needs to be culled. So thank you again for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye!